Well, greetings, Mercy Hill. This week we've been going through a series of videos focusing on Ephesians chapter 6 and the armor of God as we've been going through Fervent Prayer Week, kind of praying for our church, praying for us, for God to work within us, and using these verses and the various pieces of armor as things to focus on and acknowledge that we need God's help with. Yesterday, Kevin was looking at the belt of truth and all that that meant for us as we were going into that. Today we'll be focusing on the breastplate of righteousness. Now this particular piece of armor would be something that would cover the core of who we are, and I really feel this sense of righteousness and being able to understand this is something that will truly guard the core of our being and who God has made us to be, will help to protect us from the attacks of the enemy that would come against our identity, and be able to understand and walk into spiritual battle in our life and whatever we may face with a sense of protection, of the understanding of the righteousness of God that He has given to us. Now, righteousness within this particular passage is from Strong's number G1343, which is really talking about an acceptable state before God, or really that righteous action, the holy conduct of Jesus as He walked perfectly in this life. Now, as we see in other different passages, that when God looks at us, when we find salvation through Jesus Christ, it's as though the righteousness, the holy conduct of Jesus is credited to our account. Again, this sense of righteousness or holy conduct, an acceptable state before God, is not something we can accomplish on our own. Again, even this armor, it is the armor of God. It's not our armor, but it's armor that He has given to us. And including this is the sense of righteousness, this holy standing before God. In 2 Corinthians 5, verse 21, it says, He made the one who did not know sin to be sin for us so that we might become the righteousness of God. This is that sense of holy standing, a rightness before God where our sins are forgiven. Our actions don't earn this. It is a gift of God, as we see in Ephesians chapter 2. But rather, it is a gift given to us out of His grace and mercy that we have a righteous standing before God where we are acceptable to Him. It's only because of the work of Jesus Christ on the cross. Now, understanding the truth of this state before God, the sense of righteousness, is what guards us and who we are. Because then when Satan tries to attack us with doubt, worries, a feeling of God not loving us, us not being acceptable before Him, we all find as being false, because God made us to be righteousness because of Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Father, we come before You this day, and we are thankful that the righteousness of Jesus is what You credit to us, that when You look at us, You see what He accomplished instead of our actions here on earth. Father, I pray that that sense of being righteous before You is something that we would grasp. I pray for a revelation by Your Spirit to understand that through the blood of Christ, the forgiveness of our sins, we stand holy and righteous before You, not because of anything we've done, but simply because of the work of Jesus Christ on the cross. That, Lord, understanding and grasping the truth of being righteous would guard us, would guard our hearts, would guard the core of our identity. So as we face accusations from the enemy, as we face things in this world, that shame would not find a foothold within us, that there would be no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, because we're set free by You and we carry that righteousness, that Christ died, as we see in Corinthians, so that we might become the righteousness of God. Lord, let us be a church that walks in the truth of that identity, protected, but also willing to fight for those who are still lost in darkness. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.